We are recording.
Yeah.
I tried getting you on this show. I don't even remember how long ago. We're finally doing this. I'm really excited.
Yeah, I should have been the first one being your teacher.
Ideally.
I allow you.
Ideally.
Ideally, yeah.
Ideally, you should have been the first, but I'm busy there.
Yeah. Never mind.
How are you doing, Shibu?
I'm good now. Recovering.
Excellent. Since this is the first time that most of the listeners who've heard this show have heard of me talk about you a lot, but they've never really gotten to see you up close. Of course, there's your channels and everything, but if we...
I'm not that handsome. They get to see up close Ganja Aadmi, old guy.
You do realize that you make most young guys feel old.
After this COVID, your body feels like winded, absolutely.
It does.
This is a different virus.
That is true. But knowing you and knowing the things you know, I'm pretty sure you'll recover much faster.
Everybody hopes and thinks for that, but the second wave has really taken a toll on this country.
That is true, Shibu. Because...
Anyways, let's go ahead with the interview.
Yes. If you could... And I know you've done this 1,000 times and you've been asked this question a number of times. If you could give us a little insight into how you began, what got you to Shaolin? Because I know that you've learned a lot of systems before Shaolin as well.
There is a standard operating procedure. There's a standard answer to this question all the years. Started at 7 with my driver, Suraj Pal.
Mm-hmm.
And he was the one who used to narrate me the stories of martial arts films.
Mm-hmm.
And before he made me watch 36 Chambers, he must have narrated the story with actions and stuff so many times
mm-hmm.
that it was in my head. And when I saw that movie, saw the first scene of center being thrown, mm-hmm. just the chi, you know, I was like, when my father came, you know, I told him, Baba mujhe Shaolin monk banna hai.
Mm-hmm.
I just remember that. It's very plain and simple. And then I don't know. I think tum to shayad paida bhi nahi hua hoga tab. When I was 7.
89 years. So, I was 1989.
Yeah. So at that time, Nepal border, they had this. I don't know, in Delhi University, you know, kunji examination ki kunji abhi bhi PU mein milti hai.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So kung fu ki kunji aati thi. These thick books of kung fu.
Right.
Written in Nepali and in Hindi mm-hmm. and in English, you know, thick books with these tiger styles and all those kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So Suraj used to open those pages and make me, you know, do those actions and stuff. So that's how crazy it became.
Mm-hmm.
But since there was no kung fu teacher at that point of time, you know, I started with karate.
Right. Okay.
So that was my first martial arts.
So you started with karate and then you went to Shaolin in about 2001, right?
Yeah. I was a first dan black belt in karate, Goju Ryu karate.
Mm-hmm.
Then I did kung fu tua.
Mm-hmm.
I was second star degree black belt in that. I also had opportunity to train somewhat like Sanshao, Chinese kickboxing,
mm-hmm.
with one of my father's friends used to work in Chinese embassy.
Mm-hmm.
Chinese guy. And then I did 1 year of Kalari Poet, Southern style.
Mm-hmm.
So that was most of my martial arts before I went to Shaolin.
It's interesting that you mentioned Kalari Poet because all I've been hearing since God knows how long is Kalari is the mother of all martial arts. And I know you've mentioned this story a number of times that it's essentially Kalari did kind of come in India, but it didn't go to Shaolin per se. So can
okay,
you
so the thing is,
that?
let's like we say that, you know, we should always stick to the facts.
Hmm.
So if people claim that Bodhidharma was a founder of Shaolin Kung Fu, so Bodhidharma went at the end of 6th century. That's number one.
Hmm.
That's a fact.
That's a fact.
Shaolin fact. Temple was made for the first Indian Buddhist monk called Batuo, okay, Buddha Bhadra.
Hmm.
That was early 6th century.
Right.
Okay. When Bodhidharma came to Shaolin Temple, the abbot of Shaolin was Feng Cheng.
Mm-hmm.
He had two bodyguards.
Right.
Who were already practicing martial arts. One was staff expert, one was wrestling expert.
Hmm.
Okay. So it's absolutely not correct to say that Bodhidharma was a founder of Shaolin Kung Fu. Mm-hmm. Okay, number two, what is the birth of Kung Fu? As per the recorded text in Chinese manuals and all those things, it is 4th century.
Okay.
Martial arts started there.
That's roughly
the first martial arts. Yeah, the first martial arts of China was called Jiaodi. Jiaoli. Yeah. Later it was called Jiaodi. Currently it's known as Xiaojiao,
which is the wrestling,
which is the mother of judo.
Right. Yeah. Yeah.
So combat submission wrestling, which was used by the Chinese warlords. Okay. So it was already existing in China. So if you say, if people start claiming they don't know, like Kalaripayattu is a mother of Shaolin Kung Fu, that's a wrong statement. You know, as far as I think, is like in every country had their own indigenous fighting system, because hum bandar se aadmi bane the. And to fight, we have innate fighting skills, you know. So everybody was using their fighting methodologies to survive,
right,
basically. So that's number one. Now, what did Bodhidharma give? Bodhidharma gave Chan Buddhism. Shaolin means to achieve enlightenment through practice. You know, he said, "Pehle body achhi karo, phir dimag achha hoga. Gandi plate mein aap khana nahi khate ho."
Right.
So he took yoga and he took the breathing patterns of few animals, combined it together, and created Qigong.
Okay.
Which was the first Qigong called the Lohan Shabaso. Okay. So this Qigong was basically added in all the martial arts training of the Shaolin people. Okay. And each of the 18 monks, 18 Lohan means enlightened monks. So each of the Lohan from these Qigong exercises created 18 Lohan, the fighting forms of their own, which became pretty famous. So in Shaolin Temple, Bodhidharma is highly acknowledged as a father of Chan Buddhism. He's not acknowledged as a father of Shaolin Kung Fu. So you know, I want to say people ki bhai dusre ki bhi kahani suno, apni sirf apna bolne se kuch nahi hota. Kalaripayattu is a very old martial arts. I respect it, highly respect it. It's the pride of India. I'm an Indian.
Right.
But main ye to nahi bol sakta ki Kalaripayattu is a mother of every single martial arts in the world.
No, that's true, because
Kalaripayattu ka origin dhoondoge to kai log bolte hain ki Parashuram se, kai bolte hain Shiv hai. Ab iska to koi written record hai nahi.
That's true.
You know, science doesn't go like this.
That is true. But when it comes to because it's also I think there's also, when it comes to Shaolin, the perception has always been ki this is at the top from, like, for a lot of people, at least when I was born, which was 89, all the way through 90s, there was either Bruce Lee, there was Jackie Chan, and there were Shaolin monks or ninjas, which was a completely different category. And karte karate, there was so much mysticism around, which I'm not sure, because I haven't gone there. But all these stories of how they were completely invincible and unbeatable and all of those things. Whereas now the perception has changed again. You're in 2020s, where everyone suddenly goes, no, Shaolin monks can't fight.
True, okay. So partly it's true because they don't understand the philosophy, the deeper meaning of the Chinese martial arts, you know. But it also, as I said, it also depends. You can't take away. You see, like for example, Pikiri Tresha is 300 years old martial arts.
Right.
Okay. How old is Krav Maga?
About 60, 70 years, maybe, maximum.
100 years, maan lo. So, Shaolin martial arts, if you say 6th century onwards. It was deployed by the Shaolin monks were deployed on the borders to fight the Japanese pirates. So much of wars have been fought. Techniques have been perfected over fighting, you know. Like not even lot of people, not even, they don't even know that, you know, the China also created Miao Dao, which is a Chinese version of katana, you know, a sword, which was, it's because it's Miao Dao is like the wheat, rice, uski tarah hota hai. It was bigger than a katana. And so they created the sword to defeat the Japanese guys. So, you know, if you see the Japanese martial arts, they also respect Damo a lot Dharma for the reason of Shaolin Kung Fu, like Judo, the predecessor is Shaojia.
Right.
You see, Jiu-Jitsu, the locking, it is Chinna.
Hmm.
Okay. So, it's the practitioners these days, you know, which makes a look art, look an art, look, you know, good or bad. But this guy, a reason is very specific that there was a time at, when Kung Fu was banned in China. Adar. You were not allowed to teach Kung Fu, okay? And it was taught in a closed door. So even if the disciple was really very honest and committed, but it was not his own blood, they would not teach. They would not teach, you know, because the government had banned practicing of Kung Fu. Because in old, you see all those old films, you see, there were life and death agreements signed before they used to practice.
Challenge
matches and stuff. So none of the techniques were, you know, competitive based. You know, I would say what sports karate has done to traditional karate, Wushu has done to traditional martial arts, Chinese martial arts. You know, and if we don't propagate or pass on this knowledge, sooner or later it's going to get lost.
Right.
You know, so if you, you know, China is one of the safest country, you know, you would have never heard terror activities coming from China, China ke andar. Okay. That's why martial arts was turned into a way of healthy living.
Okay.
You know, so fighting forms were converted into well-being forms.
Right.
You know, and competitive part was added so that people can compete, showcase their skills and body ability and stuff. Now I'll come back. Now I'll come to the answer of Shaolin monks can't fight. At that time, Shaolin monks were fighting to protect the temple from wild animals, or fighting because it was being attacked randomly by a lot of people. Okay. And then when this story, 13 monks saved the Tang emperor donated a lot of money to Shaolin and asked the abbot to create a specific army, Wusang, the fighting monks. Right. And they were being used by China to fight, you know. As time passed on, all these things finished.
Right.
So the job of a monk in the temple was to cultivate a spirit. It was not to fight in the ring.
Right.
So the same martial art was used again to cultivate the spirit, you know, like to achieve enlightenment, creating good body, good mind, using a lot of energy and stuff, you know. So slowly and slowly, that aspect of martial arts started disappearing. But there were only few people who retained that essence.
Right.
Ajbi, there are masters who are so good in combat, old school combat, that when you shake their hand, you know, bhai, it's like iron's hand.
Right.
So, you know, these are the people who are also very careful in propagating the traditional, authentic Shaolin Kung Fu to foreigners. So many foreigners go, they just end up learning the forms and come back. All the new young kids of Shaolin Kung Fu, you know, who are now going to Shaolin Temple, coming back, they wear the Shaolin monk dress, and then, you know, they understand nothing about combat of Shaolin Kung Fu.
Right.
You know, and the essence of Kung Fu. Like I can say, and I can vouch after 34 years of martial arts training, that, you know, Shaolin Kung Fu is not a joke. If you understand, you can end up killing a guy with it. With one strike. So that's the difference. So like I always said, you know, they have Ti, Da, Shwe, Na, kicking, punching, wrestling, and locking.
Right.
And that is exactly like MMA.
Yeah.
So like, that's what I'm saying, that people can say that, you know, Shaolin people cannot fight, Tai Chi people cannot fight. But it is also a responsibility of martial arts and Kung Fu practitioners. Like, for example, Shifu Yanzi is doing. If you do not upgrade yourself today with time, the old will not fit into modern.
Right.
In olden times, nobody used to punch. So they used to hold the punch like this, you know. Now you have boxing and stuff, you know. Even boxing evolved. They used to fight like that. And now it's fought like that. You know, it's evolved. So Sancho is there in China, Muay Thai, you know, from Muay Chaya and Muay Boran came Muay Thai, you know. So you have to learn the basic combat kicks and punch, and then add your Shaolin traditional techniques into it to be able to fight with Kung Fu. Right. You can't, if you don't know basic kicks and punches and stuff in a free flow manner, how can you fight?
That is true.
That's what Bruce Lee did to Wing Chun, to be very honest with you.
Hmm.
For me, Jeet Kune Do is like fluid Wing Chun. And he kept improvising it.
Yeah.
But so many Wing Chun people don't want to change. They just want to get stuck with.
That is a question I want to ask you, Shibu, because when you mentioned essence of Kung Fu, at least, and I've had conversations with you. I am the, you've also made fun of me about this because my internet pe laga rehta and I keep reading about it. But when you say essence of Kung Fu, one, what is it? What is the essence of Kung Fu? Because when you look at, or essence of martial arts in general, because currently you're at a stage where modern day society looks at martial arts as either A, just violence, or something to just exercise, and all the other aspects of it are largely ignored.
You see, martial arts, the essence of Kung Fu is in the meaning, energy and timing.
Right.
Energy cultivating over a period of time through hard work.
Hmm.
So right now you're taking my interview, you are performing Kung Fu. So Kung Fu in China is used in a lot of terms.
Hmm.
You know, gaadi chalane ka Kung Fu ho sakta hai. You know, khana banane ka Kung Fu ho sakta hai. So energy and timing.
Hmm.
So when this energy and timing meets exact timing, it creates Kung Fu.
Right.
Okay. But the essence of Kung Fu is in Chan, Wu and Yi, which is Zen, which is non-violence. Wu, which is martial. Yi, which is healing and medicine.
Right.
All combined together.
Hmm.
Okay, martial is you use your skill, Adar. You know, everybody goes through that process. I've been through that process when I was training Kali. You know, I'd become pretty aggressive and stuff, which I felt is not good. You know, and then I had to go back to my Shaolin to bring my brain back to balance. Okay, so when number one, it has to be separated from sports. You know, martial arts is an art form. You know, you can't say Bharatnatyam as a sport.
Right.
No, it's not. Uska apna ek essence hai. So similarly, number one, to use your martial skills, number one is when to use it.
Right.
Okay, martial skills. Number one, you train martial arts to overcome your own fear.
Okay.
You have fear. I know. I have fear.
Yeah.
Ditu has fear. Adi must have had fear. So many people. Mayank has fear. Everybody has fear.
Right.
You have to come over your fear. That's the first purpose of doing martial arts. But if you don't try to come over your fear, then you're not a martial artist. That's number one. Number two, using martial arts to help others. अब आपकी फैमिली के साथ कुछ बुरा हो रहा है तब आप डर जाओ और यूज नहीं करो देन यू आर अ यूजलेस मार्शल आर्टिस्ट या सड़क में जरूरत है सही में किसी को तब आप यूज नहीं करते हो देन यू आर अ वर्थलेस मार्शल आर्टिस्ट इफ यू आर यूजिंग मार्शल आर्ट्स टू बुली पीपल दैट इज नॉट अ मार्शल आर्टिस्ट सो दैट इज कॉल्ड द एसेंस ऑफ मार्शल आर्ट्स एंड यू नो दे से व्हेन योर हैंड राइजेस lower your anger.
Right. Because emotional aggression.
So body, mind and spirit, everything, you know, has to be together. So martial arts, but nowadays everybody is about competition, gold medal, because it's the naukri milti hai, it's the ye aata hai, you know, sports game federation of India ka part banna hai. उससे नौकरी मिलेगी तो पैसा कमाएंगे कितनी बेल्ट टेस्ट लेनी है कितनी ग्रेडिंग लेनी है आज इतने साल हो गए तुमको मेरे साथ आई एम नॉट ग्रेडेड यू
आई बीन विद यू
पैसे ले यू नो व्हेन माय शिफू केम टू इंडिया आई आस्क्ड हिम व्हाई हैवंट यू गिवन मी एनी सर्टिफिकेट देन ही आंसर्ड मी डू यू वांट टू सर्टिफाई अदर पीपल यू वांट द सर्टिफिकेट यू वांट द एबिलिटी टू सर्टिफाई अदर पीपल You know, olden days martial arts was practiced and passed on like this. There were no paper. अब लोगों को paper चाहिए होते हैं. यहाँ पे इंडिया में इतने लोग हैं जो घर बैठे बाहर की किसी फेडरेशन से पेपर लेके आ जाते हैं और पोस्ट करते हैं. I've got an affiliation with this. So what? So what? You know, so many people. Anyways, and plus YouTube had done the magic. Online learning, the essence of teachers have gone.
Yeah,
you know, Abhi, there is more of a coach culture,
yes,
not a
there is, yes.
and student culture.
So I'm guilty of that too, because while I've made that distinction as well. Like for me, like you're my teacher, and for me, the teacher is the source. Grant one is a teacher, but he's your teacher. So for me, it's always like going from you to everyone else. But for me, if I'm teaching someone, I am not teaching them as a teacher, depending on place, because I am not the source. For me, the source is you. So I think that's one of the reasons why the coaching culture has also come in to a degree. But I've noticed the other, like other people who we've trained with or other people who've trained under you as well. I know you've never promoted being a coach, because there is a very clear distinction that you've maintained. But why do you think that has shifted now? Because whenever we look at martial arts and whenever we look at teachers, the teachers, and I don't mean this country because yahan hisab alag hai, but anyone who's here, like a teacher is always considered up here. Whereas coaches are somewhat different in that sense. So where do you think we've lost that?
You know, ऐसी बात नहीं है. I coach भी बहुत ही respectable position और काम है to you know groom someone.
Mm-hmm.
But वो गुरु से कोच में कन्वर्ट हो गया, इंग्लिश वर्ड आ गया. अब जैसे ट्यूशन में कोचिंग लेने जाते हो तो अब वैसे वो रिश्ता एक वो ना पैसे और उससे रिलेट हो गया है. मनी ट्रांसफर से,
राइट?
यू नो नॉलेज और उससे नहीं है. एंड देयर इज नो राइट, लाइक कोच वोंट हैव अ राइट टू कॉल समबडी एट मिड ऑफ द नाइट एंड स्टफ, यू नो. एंड लाइक आई नो आई कैन कॉल यू एट मिड ऑफ नाइट एंड टेल यू आधार प्लीज कम, आई वांट आई नीड योर हेल्प एंड स्टफ, एंड देन आई एक्सपेक्ट यू नॉट टू रिफ्यूज मी, एंड आई नो यू विल नॉट रिफ्यूज मी. And you have the same right as a son or as a student to ask me, you know, ask help, you know, that, and that teacher has to be there for you then.
Sure.
So the, like my relationship with my Shifu, all the Shifus, GT, Shi Heng Jun, Sita Wong, Yan Fang, you know, all the Shifus, you know, they know that, you know, if they say something, you know, I will never refuse.
Sure.
Not because of dar or because of the name Shifu. It's the love they give. Unprecedented love, affection and knowledge.
Sure.
Knowledge bhi bahut aisa nahi ki bahut jaldi dete hain, bahut dheere dheere dete hain. You know, Shifu took 15 years to give me 36 techniques of Shaolin. You know, it requires a lot of patience.
It does.
Yeah. Just for 36 technique to wait for 15 years.
We're the fast food generation, no Shibu?
Yeah.
You are the nice home-cooked meal.
No, fast food, then it's like that. Hota na, wo fast food mein wo techniques utni jaldi chalti nahi hai. Now these 36 techniques I can apply to anything.
Sure.
So old school teachers are like that. But today's world is a little different. They want fast thing. 3 mahina, 6 mahina, 4 mahina, quick results.
Sure.
So, and yeah, I get very agitated and very turned off when I see all these Shaolin, new breed of Shaolin kids, you know, doing just gymnastic and jumping around like a monkey.
Mm-hmm.
And just doing fast music. Like, anybody can do, I can also do, you know.
Yeah.
Why the hell are you even doing Kung Fu?
Mm-hmm.
We have to do like this. I wrote day before yesterday. Shifu said today, in fact, in the morning, Shifu wrote me, if you can't fight with Kung Fu, don't learn Kung Fu.
Hmm.
Yeah, you can learn aerobics. It's much better. Don't spoil the name of Kung Fu.
Right. And yet we have a lot of people who claim that they can fight but can't. And that's
because they don't love martial arts. They don't love Kung Fu. They want that name, Shaolin. They want that dress. And the worst part is, दूसरों से पैसा लेते हैं उनको बुरा भी नहीं लगता है मतलब दे नो कि वो एकदम परम बेवकूफ बना रहे हैं बच्चों का और खुल के बनाते हैं सो एनीवेज या
आई लाइक दिस पार्ट शिफु वेयर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट ओल्ड स्कूल टीचर्स एज वेल बिकॉज़ अभी जैसे आपने कहा था लाइक ब्रूस ली व्हेन ही केम टू विंग चन ही इवॉल्वड इट इवॉल्वड इनटू समथिंग एल्स द नेम गॉट रिमूव्ड एंड ठीक है लाइक विद दैट आई एम गोइंग टू कीप मार्शल आर्ट्स पॉलिटिक्स असाइड बिकॉज़ दैट्स अ होल डिफरेंट आर्गुमेंट
या
वेयर डज वन व्हाट वुड एवोल्यूशन ऑफ दीस आर्ट्स ऑफ दीस ट्रेडिशनल सिस्टम्स लुक लाइक फॉर यू फॉर एग्जांपल बिकॉज़ आपके पास इतना एक्सपीरियंस है ट्रेडिशनल मार्शल आर्ट्स का राइट एंड I've seen you train, I've seen you spar with people, I've seen you go up against, and I've seen you show all of these techniques as well. And yes, they work. But for a lot of people who kind of, if you were to look at martial arts spectrum today, everything more or less has started looking the same. Right? Wahi punches hain, wahi jab cross, hook cross, kickboxing combination.
Tum bhi earphone use kar rahe ho, abhi main ek earphone laga lun to... बस ब्रांड का फर्क है
राइट
ये कपड़ा है अरविंद मिल का डेनिम जींस के ब्रांड्स अलग है यू सी यू नो यू कैन कॉल इट मोइथाई एल्बो यू कैन कॉल इट पिकरी टर्शिया एबिसिडारियो मानो मानो सेट नंबर 6 or 7 ऑफ एबिसिडारियो एल्बोस ओके यू कैन कॉल यू हजाओ 6 हार्मनी एल्बोस ऑफ शाओलिन एल्बो इज एल्बो Punch is punch. You know, this is a straight punch. You know, Kung Fu has 7 punches. So this is the first punch. This is the second punch. This is the third punch. Fourth punch. Fifth punch. Okay. Sixth punch. And the seventh punch. Hammer fist.
Chiba.
Okay, 7 punches. Then they have the 7 open palm techniques. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So you have one. You have Byuji. You have this, chop inside, outside, palms. Wing Chun has the same thing.
Right.
It's just that one art form took a particular aspect of it and explored that one too much. Shaolin, Sancho use side kick a lot as a primarily. Muay Thai uses roundhouse kick. The karate use mawashi giri, mai giri, taekwondo, spin around kick. Okay, BJJ like to go down to the ground and do it. Okay, if you see the old manuals of martial arts, they had the complete stuff. Aisa nahi tha.
Right.
Over a period of time, you know, people started choosing ki hum isko itne rakhenge aur sports bante bante wo katta gaya. 3 days back, I posted a video with Shifu. I just found it on my hard drive.
Right.
That's cool. There are very rare teachers in Shaolin who still teaches that. I had no experience of wrestling. I learned from him only straight away. So just I think I was fortunate enough to learn that. And then nowadays I think I've become a little bit more blunt and stuff in terms of like what works, what doesn't work. You know, like any child, you know, when you get a new stuff, you know, you get pakad lete aap usko.
Right. Yeah.
Maine kali pakda hua tha bahut time tak. You know, and but you've been training. You're my senior instructor, Jeet Kundo. You know, I want to ask anybody, parry salute. Right. It will not work against a straight punch. Never.
Yeah.
Never. Means they can debate with me, they can whatever he said, you can hate me, you can ignore me, but you cannot deny this.
Yeah.
That if I just snap a finger jab, by the time you do this, it's gone.
Gone.
It's gone. So they also need to try and evolve.
True.
You know, they can't keep training passively when somebody's punching one and two, and you go one, two, three. Happening.
So where is this paradox? Where does this paradox come from then? Because with martial arts culture, as it has been through decades, it's always been the teacher will give you, the teacher will give you the instructions and they'll give you the material, whatever they have. Like you've given to me, you know, you've given to Jeetu sir and everyone else as well. And your teachers have given to you.
But both of you move differently.
But both of us move differently. Right? But when you look at, and the same story is with a lot of these other people that you've mentioned as well. A lot of this new breed of instructors and new breed of martial artists who's come in traditional martial arts, not modern. Where they've also got the same, I mean, the curriculum is the same. The syllabus is the same. The teaching style is the same. But where is it that they falter when it comes to the evolution of it? Because like you...
Ego.
You,
ego. 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 Very simple term. Ego. You know, like they've got stuck to the name.
Right.
They got stuck to the name. My system is better than yours. You know, this is Bruce Lee said, Jeet Kune Do is just a name. Keep evolving. You know, today I realized the value of what Siddha always used to tell me. That is not 3E what you're doing. This is not 3E what you're doing. You know, when I used to do Kali, he used to say, this is not 3E. You're wasting your energy. You're wasting your motion. I never realized. Last 2 months, especially 1.5, 2 months in Gurukul, I just realized that, you know, he was so correct in terms of, you know, wasting so much of energy. You know, I've canceled so much of online sessions of PTK, you can't imagine. Canceled. I just don't, because I don't feel like teaching. Because if I don't believe in it, I don't want to teach it.
Which sounds surprising to me a little bit, because it's also the art that you brought here and you've taught like militaries. And,
yeah. But I say PTK is very deadly when it comes to knife.
Yes, that is true.
It's like unapologetically very dangerous when it's dealing with blades and knives.
Right.
Buda hote hote aadmi ko wisdom aa jati hai, to main sochta hu ki main 45 saal mein main kiska khoon karunga bhai. Who am I gonna stab?
That is
even true. If I get a chance to kill someone, will I really put a knife through his gut?
No. No. Yeah.
I will not do that. Because I have to think of 10,000 repercussions after that.
Right.
And I really started believing in... okay, one part of Kali is good. It's like, okay, defang the snake like Paul Monarch says. Cut his hand. Cut the weapon hand. You can finish the fight there, you know.
Right.
So there's a lot of things you can do, you can train, you know, but like in street, you know, it's a little different. Again, it's a very debatable or paradox. Someone said that your
knowledge
is on you. In an act of self-defense, of course, I'll do what I have to do.
Yeah.
Okay. But to train civilians, kill, that I will not do. Okay, you've been training Kali with me. You've seen so many Kali people. Tell me how many of them can fight empty hands.
Remove the
stick from the hand.
On record, not many.
How many of them have ever fought functionally, free sparring?
I doubt. I doubt if many have. Empty hand for sure. Not a lot. Empty hand for sure.
That's what I thought. That's what I call evolving. MMA evolved. So guys, you also need to test your Pangamuth and Dumog.
Yeah.
Against a seasoned grappler or a seasoned fighter, pro fighter. Mm. Like, just don't say my stick is gonna blow your brain off. If you don't have the stick, then my thing is, if you train an MMA fighter into Pikiri Tertia, he'll become more dangerous than a Pikiri guy.
That's true. That is true. Because they have that base of, they have that
the whole purpose of creating Shifu Kanishka combatives was that I didn't know what name to give Adhar, to be very honest with you.
We went through so many iterations.
My name, that's okay. That's my way.
Right.
Of, no. But technically, I still feel that 3 is a very apt name.
Mm.
You know?
Yeah.
3 is a pretty apt name. I wanted to give the name Shield. Remember, you made a logo.
I did,
but
yes.
Shield was already a copyright because it protects you from a lot of things. And, you know, you can call it more like a dirty MMA. Mm. That's what, you know, we can use the term as dirty MMA. That's what, if you have to say. Yeah. So, but like I said that, you know, Pikiti is very dangerous in certain areas, like Wing Chun, in close quarters, you know, because you can bite, you can do like this, which Paul Wunak does with rat and stuff. Okay. Muay Thai is also very dangerous in a particular area. Kicking is dangerous in a particular area. If you say mixed martial arts, Jeet Kune Do is MMA.
That's true.
For street. You know, so like you're saying, naam se kuch farak itna padta nahi hai. Aap kisi bhi cheez ko blend kar lo. But my only thing is, blend only if you have mastered one martial arts. Then blend. Otherwise, you'll become very hollow from inside. You right. need to have a strong base of one martial arts. And those who must be listening, you know, my purpose of saying like this doesn't work is not about demeaning any system. I was the one who got Pikiti in India. I was the one who got Shaolin Kung Fu in India or Progressive Fighting System, PFS or JKD, all those things. But I'm just talking that there is a place and time for every martial arts.
Right.
You know, like PTK especially, they have a lot of thrusting-based drill. Because why? Thrusting is more dangerous than slashing other.
Yes.
With you a knife. Slash here. A knife here, you know, get stuck or maybe just stuck it here. But when you puncture a knife, it will go through my body.
Yes.
Here, Pikiti is very dangerous because everything is thrusting-based. The knife goes 2-3 inches inside the bones. Through the flesh, it creates immense bleeding. That's why it's apt suited for military. That's why it's apt suited for military to train PTK edge weapon program.
Right. So one thing that a lot of people don't talk about, or at least I don't hear a lot of people talk about, is we've covered two aspects of the martial art essence, right? There's Zen, which is the more mindfulness, staying in the moment side. Focus and character development. Then there's the martial side, which is the Wu, which is the fighting and self-defense and all of that. The healing, I haven't heard a lot of people talk about.
The healing, because a lot of people do. A lot of people don't study. Because the healing part of Shaolin is like, A is learn how to massage, Tuina. Okay, the other is Qigong. Third is, I also haven't studied that part because, you know, you have to stay in China for 3-4 years, study the language. And those medicines, you can't grow in India, those herbs.
Right,
the TCM, the traditional Chinese medicine. So I jitna main kar sakta tha, like the massage part and the Qigong. So I do that.
Right.
For healing.
Yeah.
But I'll give you one example. Abhi recently in this last camp. I was talking about Shaolin combat and Tan Feng Ba, and Amar was there, Sahil's student. And I just hit him, boom, and he flew. And 2 sessions before, I told them break fall. He forgot. He kept his hand like this. He felt the shoulder came up here. Pop. Okay. If I wouldn't have known how to relocate the shoulder back to the socket, then that guy would have been in excruciating pain. So I put it back, then I send him to the doc, you know, so doc said it's fine, you know, so it's already its place and stuff. He iced it up, but that he realized, A, he realized how dangerous the Kung Fu was.
Hmm.
B, that healing was very important. Teacher must know how to fix.
Chiba.
Yeah. So, that's why it's like yin and yang.
Hmm.
So, but yeah, plus...
Other, but do other have it too?
One more thing which I wanted to tell you was, I didn't complete that day, that time. It's like when people mix their martial arts, like blind devotion, like for example, Krav Maga.
Hmm.
But Krav Maga is from Israel.
Hmm.
You look at the build of the people in Israel, it's different. It's a very brute force system. Okay. Number one. Number two, because people want quick fix, you know, like for example, so they borrow from everything. So they punch and block like Jeet Kune Do.
Hmm.
But after that, they don't know
what comes next.
A JKD guy can transfer, or maybe a Wing Chun guy can does it. So what I mean to say is, like, you need to study systems in detail before you blend them.
Mm.
You know, every counter has a recounter.
Yeah.
And Krav Maga is not a knife-based system. How can you understand knife better than a Filipino guy? Where 80% of the killing is done by knife.
Right. You'll have to go to the source.
So when you have to deal with the knife, you have to deal with the best system which is existing. And for me, the best system existing with knife is Pikiri Tertia.
Hmm.
When it goes to extreme close quarter, I think Balintawag is highly dangerous. You've seen that.
Yes. Yes.
Another system which I really love is Than Miguel Escrima.
Hmm.
It teaches me the combination of long and short weapon. This Paradaga is tremendous.
Right. There's another one you did which was more empty hand for knife.
So that is called Borosugbo. Okay.
Right.
Mm. Arnes Diablo.
Mm.
Okay. It's just knife to empty hand.
Mm.
You know, so aise to main list kyun, I think I must have now done around 10 martial arts.
I'm keeping a record, Jibu.
Yeah. So the thing is, SKC, my R system also, Adar, is evolving. You know, what I see now, for last 2 months, I've been trying to evolve SKC.
Mm.
And I'm going to sit down now, in next week.
Mm.
I'm going to restructure the syllabus. The foundation will remain the same.
Right.
We made the deal. Foundation is the same. But I'm going to change level 2, 3.
Mm.
Evolving means I'm going to cut down.
Mm.
A lot of crap. I'm going to keep it very simple and very straight.
Mm.
So that it becomes very easy for people to learn.
Sure.
But it should have an essence of Shaolin.
Yes.
It should have essence of Jeet Kune Do and Wing Chun and Pikiri Tertia Kali and Balintawak. So our knife part has and stick part has to be a blend of Samrada Sabayan and Balintawak grouping.
Right.
Together.
Mm.
So the last two phase of SKC is very detailed and in depth. So yes. That is like being a closed door student. The first two part anybody can learn.
Right.
Very generic and general. It's like an MMA.
Yeah.
But the last two phases, because you need Chi Sao, you need Hubert, Tai Chi wrestling, push hands, grappling, and all that rat. And so it's like rat and PTK and, you know, Tai Chi and Shaolin, everything is like in one box like this. Shaken up together.
Chi Sao, very important. Because your martial arts, I think you're one of the few people who's actually mentioned that you don't need and you shouldn't try for brute force. Like the entire system, even with your amount of power, and I felt it, has always been very soft power. Why do you think that that has not been either talked about as much or promoted as much?
Okay, Adar, let's play the game. Stone, paper, scissor. Hmm. Ready?
Hmm.
Right? Again. One. Who wins?
You win. You win.
okay. Go, go. Go. Who win? You.
I do.
Okay. Go. One more time. Hmm. Go. Who win?
You win.
Okay. Why? That's your answer.
Hmm. Paper softer than.
That's your answer.
Yeah.
Yeah. Papers wraps around.
Hmm.
Covers. 9 Pro.
Hmm.
Should I drop it to the floor?
It'll break.
Breaks.
Yeah.
Drop here. Bounces back.
Bounces. Yeah.
So soft is like that lattu hota na.
Hmm.
Us pe aap chalk marte ho, it just rebounds.
Right. Yeah.
And soft does not mean weak, Adhar. Strong does not mean hard and right. rigid.
Hmm.
People fail to understand this.
Hmm.
Soft does not mean weak. Strong doesn't mean rigid.
Hmm.
There has to be a fine balance in the two.
Right.
To be able to feel the energy, redirect. You know, Master Wong always used to tell me, 10 ton of elephant, 50 ton of train, boom, elephant dies. 50 ton of train going like this, 10 ton elephant hits the train, the whole train derails.
Yeah.
That's why you see, when you see the triangle system, a lot of people go from side, boom, hit. You can push the guy from here very far, not from front.
Not from front, yes.
Bike guy, the bike is coming like this and you hit the bike like this, he's going to fall.
Yeah.
People have these evasive footwork. They move side, quarter turns. Why? The Muay Thai, they say, Chak Sai, Jeet Kundo, we say quarter turns and stuff.
Mm.
Because you let the guy go. What is sprawling? A force is coming like this. You see?
Yeah.
Sprawling. You understand sprawling? You see? If it stays here,
you I'm fall.
Boom.
Yeah.
When I do like this,
it's easy.
That's the concept of sprawling.
Right.
Let the force go in. You go over it.
Why do you think a lot of... because this is... I've attended a lot of workshops with you. I've assisted you in a lot of workshops, specifically for women as well. Mm. And I think because this is a concept that has not been communicated to a lot of people. I think it's like martial arts has always been very male dominated in a lot of ways. There are some examples of women as well. Mm. But why is it still so male dominated? Why is there like an aversion from, say, women to join martial arts?
Because I know, Adhar, I think internal martial arts, softer martial arts takes a lot of time to study.
Hmm.
People, like I said, na, people do not like to be called weak or soft. They say he's doing so soft. They say Tai Chi people doing, oh, he's moving so soft. But they don't understand the power of that softness.
Hmm. Right.
You know, they have to have these biceps and strong brute force. So... it depends on person to person.
Mm.
It's difficult to learn soft martial arts, but it's very devastating.
How would you bring that into life in general? Like if for someone who's kind of not been able, for someone who's training in these arts, let's say. I think the easiest correlation to make is
practically making them show when they come here. First hand experience.
Mm-hmm.
That's the only way to. And once you get a habit of learning soft martial arts, you don't want to do hard style.
Yeah. I think in past couple of days, I've been only wanting to do Qigong and not anything on the bag or kick or punch or anything of that sort.
Qigong and yoga, pranayam, you know, to fix the body.
Hmm.
It's again, see, energy, healing.
Yeah. How would you bring the lifestyle into it, Tripu? Because I think one thing that where a lot of people fail, at least modern day, is just it. Purane time mein, it was relatively easy because it was a very fixed lifestyle. You didn't have so many distractions. You didn't have to You didn't have to think about a job. You didn't have to kind of live in these houses, get on calls. But from a lifestyle perspective, for someone who's not training to be a full-time martial artist, how do they incorporate a lot of what they learn in training? And I'm talking about all three things, which is the martial art, the character development, and the healing. How do they bring it into life or like a day, for example? What could it look like?
It reflects in everything you do, Agar. Like if you're training martial arts, you know, your reaction time, your response, your ability to respond to anything, you know, your snappiness and answering back, even verbally, you know, or countering a thing, fighting a disease, like what we are doing right now.
Yeah.
People can give up mentally. They give up. I've seen young people, younger martial artists than me. They've died. You know, people are, you know, falling apart. 90% is the brain.
Right.
You know, which works. So this is all is a perfect example of, you know, martial arts is about the first, the essence of martial art is like get up and fight back. You know, when you started training with me or I started training with my teacher, you know, he must have done a sweep on me. He must have thrown me down. And every time he told me, get up, fight back, get up. Fight back. Now that fight back doesn't really mean that physically fighting. Nah? It's about you are down financially, physically, mentally. Get up, fight back.
Yeah.
Get up, fight back.
Right. I remember our old training sessions. I've been knocked around with pads and you asked me to get up. Like, yes, Shivu. Shivu, I'm going to move to my second last question, which is, for someone right now, given the current circumstance, with so much chaos happening everywhere, I've always felt that some martial arts lessons are universal. You don't need to be a martial artist to know them. What are some of the things that people can probably use right now to just build a better lifestyle for themselves and just a better life mentally, physically?
Every day, push the sky. That's the first thing to do. Fight Corona today is the most important thing. So, Shaolin, Jing Palm is very good.
Sure.
You know, foot direction, so up, side, right. Front,
down,
exhaling of the chest, and Badwan Jain, okay, shoot the eagle. That's the physical part of it. Every day train this, or if you're into pranayam, do pranayam. You know, do meditation. I don't disintegrate all these things from martial arts. They're all part of it.
Sure.
Yeah, but as far as fighting aspect is concerned, you know,
how would you develop the mindset, so to speak? Because I think a lot of what we're facing or looking at right now is not just the physical repercussions of disease or illness, and COVID is one example, is what I would say. I'm sounding a little insensitive when I say this because it is very dangerous and a lot of people have suffered right now. But disease as a whole is a function in my mind of the body and this. Like, if your mind is not addressed, you may be like the fittest or the supposedly physically healthiest person on the planet, but you're not really healthy because this will make you ill further. How would you cultivate a mindset every day or just in general to get that essence of I will get up, I will fight back?
So keep saying to yourself, I believe in life, not in death. I believe in success, not in failure. Life, success. Okay. Willpower, determination.
Sure.
Like when you ask me something, Shifu, how are you feeling? I said, I have put COVID into Chinna.
Yeah.
It's just, I'm telling myself, I'm telling you, Adar, I'll jeet kyun the Chinna. Means I'll intercept it. I will kill this guy.
Yeah.
You know, I will not let the disease destroy me.
Sure.
Your body starts producing hormones like this.
Sure.
you know, somebody is asking me, you know, they were expecting me to respond that I'm in excruciating pain. I'm feeling very bad. Everybody who asked me, how are you doing? Oh, I'm recovering. I've already put COVID in Chennai. They never asked me second question. It's like, oh, okay. That's good to hear.
You're fine.
Why? When you're already there's already negativity. You're already fighting. Why do you need to hear?
Yeah.
When trouble comes to trouble, you trouble the trouble more. Very simple.
Yes.
Let's see how much COVID can trouble us.
I doubt it can. I've already kicked its ass.
That's it. That's the attitude.
True.
You answered the question. The attitude.
True.
Seeing you people, you are kicking COVID. I also felt like Aadhar can do it. I will also do it.
True.
Age doesn't make a difference. That's the only attitude.
True.
That's the answer to your question.
I saw my mother.
Positive. Yeah. That's it. My mom did it.
Yeah.
Mom did it.
Right, Shibu. My last question, where can these people reach out to you? Where can they learn from you? Are you doing online sessions at all right now?
Okay, so
there's a camp coming.
You can reach out to me on team2hornkanishka@gmail.com.
Sure.
Okay. Yeah, and my website, like you can already know, kanishkasharma.info.
Sure. Okay.
Mm-hmm. And like we have decided, you, me, Deepika, Megha, and Jitu is here. That's Neil, our core team. So, if they want to learn Jeet Kune Do, you know, they can write officially to me.
Sure.
And, you know, if I don't have the time, and you know, mostly I don't teach, you know that. So, Jeet Kune Do, I want you to teach.
Sure.
PTK, I want Jeet to teach and stuff. Few sure. people who I want to teach, I will teach personally. Sure. But after 15 days, once we are fully recovered, I want to start doing a lot of SKC webinars. A lot of SKC webinars.
Right.
I want to be focusing a lot on SKC.
Mm-hmm.
And within that umbrella, you know, knife work, stick works of SKC, trapping of SKC, everything with SKC I want to do.
Right.
Yeah.
And there's
a lot of webinars to come.
Excellent. There's also the Gurukul camp I think you're doing in May.
Yeah. May, but let's see how the situation is.
Right.
We'll keep people posted. The event, the date will be posted in shaolinindia.com.
Mm-hmm.
So, abhi to 21st to 30th hai.
Right.
But let's see.
Let's see.
Yeah.
Right, Shibu. Thank you so much for doing this.
Okay.
It was so long. Thank you.
Yeah.